So I'll be talking about thrombocytopenia in ICU. So I think this question was asked in one of the DNP question papers, I think in year 2008 or 2010, whatever. So the topics that I will be covering is platelet basics, the epidemiology, the time course of thrombocytopenia, prognostic significance, and causes and differential diagnosis, so which would predominantly fall into sepsis, drugs, and HIV. Investigations, treatment, and take-home message. So I think when you look at the function of platelets, predominantly it has two functions. So one is the hemostasis, which is to stop bleeding, and as a prothrombotic state. So it can create thrombosis in major blood vessels, including veins and arteries. So when you look at the platelet, not only does it have hemostasis and prothrombotic, it also produces certain factors called procoagulant factors and pro-inflammatory factors. And some of the procoagulant factors that are produced are platelet activating factors and complement proteins. And some of the pro-inflammatory factors that are produced are cytokines and oxidants. So what is the consequence of platelet activation? So the platelet, when it gets activated, it can have beneficial effects and harmful effects. So some of the beneficial effects is it can cause wound healing, I think, which is very useful. So the platelet activation is needed for facilitating wound healing. And another important function is to maintain the endothelial integrity in the vessels, blood vessels. So basically, platelets are needed to maintain the endothelial integrity to prevent vascular leakages. And it reduces the vascular permeability. So this is extremely useful in conditions like dengue or any other multi-organ dysfunction due to viral sepsis, because the predominant pathophysiological mechanism is vascular, extensive vascular leakage. So I think platelets are needed, because typically in any disease condition where you see fall in platelet count, I think the pathognomonic finding would be the loss of vascular integrity due to the endothelial spaces which get disrupted. So I think platelet function is needed to maintain the integrity. And it is also useful for inflammatory and host defense. I think it has a pro-inflammatory and anti-inflammatory effect, so which is useful for host defense mechanism. So the harmful effects, I think thrombocytopenia can lead to impairment of the capillary network. Because what typically happens is when platelets get activated, there will be prothrombotic state. So there will be platelet clumps that gets formed in the microcirculation. So that can lead to tissue hypoxia and organ dysfunction. And there can be cascading of this anti-inflammatory or pro-inflammatory effect and worsening of coagulopathy due to platelet activation. So these are some of the broad headings under which beneficial effects and harmful effects of thrombocytopenia or platelet activation happen. So why is platelet pathology harmful? Because the platelet has a direct effect on organ dysfunction. So when there is a platelet abnormality, it can lead to organ dysfunction. And it can lead to bleeding. As we already mentioned, thrombocytopenia can lead to bleeding. And even thrombocytopenia can be associated with a prothrombotic phase like ITP or TTP. TTP, mainly TTP and HUS, where it is a prothrombotic state in the presence of thrombocytopenia.